boy.
And
he's epileptic. Often time he fell into the fire. Sometimes into the water. The other day his father brought the son before Jesus, and Jesus was from the mountain. He came down the mountain and he was with Peter, John, and James. In the mountain, Jesus transfigured. Elijah appeared, Moses appeared. When Jesus met the man down the mountain, this man said unto Jesus, I brought my son to your disciples, they appointed you. It was at a time when Jesus dispatched his disciples to go on healing people and casting demons. When they came back, they came excited. They were jubilant and they said, demons were going sick, diseases were being healed. And Jesus said unto them, don't rejoice over this, but rejoice that your names are written in the book of life. When they were giving him a report, they lied in one point. They did not tell Jesus that in all the sick people that we met, there is a boy we failed to kill. And this boy was epileptic. When the man met Jesus at the mountain, he's now reporting the disciples that I brought my son to your disciples. Jesus turned around and he said, this matter cannot be solved except by prayer and fasting. This was a higher level than the disciples. It will take them prayer and fasting for them to solve the problem. And the Bible declares, when the man was explaining the disease, that the boy fell into fire, sometimes into water. The epileptic disease, it was an element disease. It was declared, or it was influenced by a moon. Whenever the moon arises, it would strike the boy. The boy would fall into fire. Now I want you to pay attention. He wasn't falling in the ground. He wasn't hitting a stone. Time and again, whenever he falls into fire, into water, it was a demonic arrangement that every time when the moon rises, the boy is closer to the fire or closer to the water, he can't be anywhere. He will never be anywhere. When the moon rises up, it was a demonic arrangement. It was a demonic focus. It was a satanic calendar. That whenever the moon rises, the boy should be by the fire. When the moon strike him, he fall into the fire or into the water. Now hear me well. When he fall into the fire, the fire wasn't burning him. When he fall into the water, the water wasn't choking him. In other words, the water and the fire had no effect in his life. Now be of this attention, that from the mountain, Jesus met Elijah and Moses. And Moses, if you please, is a water man. Because in the entire ministry of Moses, Moses is a water man. The name Moses, he's drawn from water. When Jochebed, the mother of Moses, gave birth to Moses, she took him into a basket and laid him by the Nile River. The first miracle Moses did was to strike the rivers in Egypt. the waters became bloody. The next thing that Moses does, he stood before the Red Sea. And the people cried to God. And the Lord said unto Moses, what do you have in your hand? He said, I've got a rod strike the water. And the waters parted into two. When they were the other side of the water, they are chaining the wilderness. And the sun was crushing them. And people are thirsty. And the Lord said unto Moses, there is a rock by you. Strike the rock. And water protruded out of the water. Hear me well. When people were in the wilderness, the Lord said unto them, I will walk over you as a cloud. And what is a cloud? Cloud is water that was hit by the sun and it evaporated and formed a condensation, and there was a cloud formation. Moses is a waterman. On the other side of Moses, there is a prophet in the name Elijah, and Elijah is a fireman. The ministry of Elijah was confirmed by fire. He stood before the prophet of Baal and he declared unto them, we're gonna pray. The God who answered by fire, he is a real God. And fire came down. The other day, Moses is up the mountain. And the Bible says, or rather Elijah is up the mountain. And the Bible says, there was a captain. He was sent with the 50 soldiers. They stood at the foot of the mountain and declared unto Elijah, Elijah, come down. And Elijah said, if I be a man of God, let fire fall. And the Bible says, fire fell and consumed the 50. It happened for the second time. We learn by the books that Elijah came with Elisha. They came from Gilgal. They came to Bethel. The Bible declared again, they crossed the river Jordan. And Elijah said unto Elisha, what do you want from me? Elisha said, I want the double portion of your spirit. Elijah said, you ask a difficulty, but nevertheless, if you see me go, thou shalt receive of it. As they were still conversing, they were separated by a whirlwind, and Elijah was carried to heaven in the horses and the chariots of fire. Elijah is a fireman. Now there in the mountain, Jesus met the fireman and he met the waterman. When he got down from the top of the mountain, he meets a man and the challenge of the boy. This boy sometimes he fall into the water, sometimes into the fire. And who is this water that the boy is falling into? And who is this fire that the boy is falling into? This water is Moses. This fire is Elijah. In other words, the scriptures are saying, by revelation, the boy fell into Moses. And Moses is the author of the law. In other words, this boy fell into the law. And the law couldn't heal him. When the law failed the boy, this boy fell into the fire. And the fire is Elijah. And Elijah is the prophet. Hear me well. This boy fell into the prophets, and the prophets couldn't heal him. Now the father said, when the prophet failed me, when the law failed me, I brought my son to you. Even before I bring him to you, I took him to your disciples. The disciples you prayed for, they couldn't heal him. They were anointed to solve the problem of the boy. Peter was there, but Peter couldn't make it. Am I speaking to anybody?
Hallelujah.
Anointed to solve the problem, but they can't solve the problem anyway. Moses,
Moshe,
are you not a man of miracles? We saw you throw down the rock and it became a serpent. We saw your hand, it was leprous. You took it back to your bosom and your hand was restored again. Moses,
Moshe,
we saw you declare to the ground. In the days of Korah, it parted into two, and Korah was swallowed alive. Are you not a man of miracles? By your hand we saw the Lord parting the Red Sea. Why can't you deal? It's not enough. We saw it happening in the days of your son Joshua, when he stopped the sun. The sun stood still. What is a moon to you? What is a moon strike to you? Why can't you solve this
problem?
Moses failed as well. Elijah, you caught fire. The fire that licked the sacrifice. Why can't you call fire to lick epileptic? It couldn't solve the boy, but he was brought to Jesus. What the law cannot do, what Moses cannot do, what the prophet cannot do, what Elijah cannot do, is there anything too hard for the Lord? He declared, I am God of all flesh. What is impossible with man, it is possible with God. Am I speaking to anybody?
Hallelujah.
Hear me and understand. The physicians couldn't heal the lady. Although they went under the class, they were taught to solve the problem. When the problem presents, they don't have the audacity to settle the problem. There's only one person who can solve this problem. It's not everything that even people who are trained to solve are able to solve. It was when Elijah disappeared. When Moses disappeared. And Jesus solved the problem they couldn't. And when he was solving the problem Moses and Elijah couldn't solve, it was in the absence of Elijah and Moses. You couldn't do it, I will not do it in your presence, you must be gone.
Do you know why the Lord do some things in the absence of certain
people?
Especially the things that people thought that these are the people that are that can do such a thing. In their presence, the Lord make it
Mudimu aba dismiss.
Then the Lord chased them away.
Ha diriselo se baleho.
He doesn't orchestrate the thing while they are still
ha dira baleho enna o kare Mudimu mo competitioning le go dira se ba paletsong ke go se dira ha compete.
When he does what they still there, it is more like they are in competition.
Leka so se khonang o tsamaya ga sna na o tsamaya ke sala ke dira so sa se khonang mo bosong jago.
Then I will remain doing what you are supposed to be doing in your absence. What I did in your absence will announce to you